Alright, back at the pool, another day. This one's gonna be a hot one. It's already like, it was 90 degrees at 10 o'clock. And right now, it's gonna get like up to 100 maybe. Look at the kids, all having some fun. These guys about to go to the big pool. We're going there. So, yay, at the pool, we're gonna have some fun. We're gonna get some cool down. Some people need it right now. We gotta cool down with the waters. Some slides. Big koi thing in them there. Slides over there. I don't think we'll go to the slides over there. The kids are too small for that. So we're gonna be able to do that right now. Let's go. Alright, so like I thought it would be, it's a hot one. It was already like really hot this morning, and so it's up to 102 degrees right now. I thought it was gonna be a little bit cooler than that. I thought, because originally the thermometer said 104, and I thought that can't be right, you know, so I waited a little bit and yay, it dropped 2 degrees and it's now only 102. So it's really hot and it was so good to go dip in the pool. But right now I'm exhausted, I'm tired because I'm in the pool. So it was hot. So now I'm gonna just go ahead and grab some crickets because I haven't fed those freaking frogs in like forever. Oh, it would be a shame if they died. But no, really, I really should try to keep them alive.
Alright, Wednesday. It's Wednesday, right? Uh-huh. Yeah, Wednesday. And we're going off to DC to Discovery Theater, and we're going to see some dancing and all that cool stuff. There's probably no filming there, so I probably won't be able to film anything that's in there, but maybe take quick pictures, I don't know. But anyways, let's get going.
Right here at the Marble Street. Wow. Right this way. Right here, sir. All right. Before we start, we would like to know your name and what camp you're representing. Nice and loud for everyone to hear. Go ahead. Do some science, but we have to keep safety in mind. Science can be dangerous. So, Mason, I have for you here a lab coat. Please put this on for me. Yep.
Please.
All right.
Uh-oh.
Couple more things. We need some goggles. I have these goggles here, and you get goggles too. You look like this. Please put this on. Awesome. You look cool. Couple more things. Well, really just one more thing. We need some gloves. I have these gloves here. You get gloves too, but your gloves are pink.
Lucky.
Hey, pink's a cool color.
Lucky.
Right now, we're going to pretend that we're both in second grade. Because when I was in second grade, my favorite thing to do when the weather was this hot was to have water gun fights. You guys like water gun fights?
Yeah! Cool.
We're gonna have a water gun fight, but it's science style. Because in here, I put some blue ink. You kind of see the blue-purpley liquid in there. It's safe and non-toxic, which means it won't hurt us, but we're still wearing the safety equipment. To set a good example, Mason, this is your water gun. Hold on to that. Excellent. Just point it down for a second. Good. Right. Now, if you get a water gun, I get one too. It's a water gun fight. And I brought actually the same one that I used to use when I was in second grade. I never lost because my water gun looks like this. Do you have any last words? I'm going down. I'm good last words. Okay. On three, you squirt it at me. I squirt it at you. Ink lower, please. Okay. Good. All right. Let's get a little bit of music for this. Okay. One, two, three. All right, that's it. I think I definitely won. Can you face the audience there with your side? Yes, I definitely won. All right, I'll take the water gun there. The ink is fading away. If you notice, it's almost all disappeared. Face the audience for me one more time. It's almost all gone, okay? It's disappearing because this is actually disappearing ink, or invisible ink. It changes colors from blue to clear. Have you guys ever played with disappearing ink before? Some people? You have too. Excellent. It disappears, it changes colors because it absorbs a gas that's in the air all around us. The air we're breathing is a mixture of different gases, and a little bit of the gas that's in the air is carbon dioxide. I got a tough question. Does anyone know where the carbon dioxide comes from? How does it get into the air? Trees close, but not quite. Trees make oxygen. We're looking for carbon dioxide. What do you think? Comes from us breathing out. Yes, guys, give them a round of applause. You guys like the rainbow?
Yeah.
How does it work? Bubbles are bubbling here, and they're rising out of this little straw right there. And I'm going to fill up a can of sour cream and onion Pringles that I emptied before the show.
Those are
your favorite. Great. And we're going to fill this up with some hydrogen gas. Just like that. It's bubbling up here, and it's rising and filling up this can. The can is filling up with gas that can go on fire very easily. So, if I light that can on fire right now, nothing would happen. That's because to have anything burn, whether it's hydrogen, gasoline, a candle, paper, food, whatever it is, you need two other things besides the fuel. This is the fuel, we already have it, but we need two other things, three things in total. Do you guys know what the two other things we're missing are? What do you think?
Heat.
Heat, excellent. We need heat or fire, something to get it started. A candle doesn't burst into flames. You need to provide the heat. That was this. This one's not working. This. And one other thing. This one's a little bit harder. All the way back there.
Oxygen.
Oxygen. Give a round of applause. When you breathe in, you use up some oxygen from the air and you're burning something. You're burning the food that you ate earlier today. All right, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take the can filled with the fuel, place it right here, and remove a little piece of tape on top that's covering up a very small hole. That allows the air to mix in, which has the oxygen. Then I provide the fire, and we might see and hear a lot of energy. Sometimes this one is very loud. So when I tell you to, I need everybody to cover their ears. Let's get a little bit of suspenseful music. Well, too suspenseful, all right. Please cover your ears, especially all you guys in the front.
That was loud.
The premiere of the Batman Dark Knight.
Yeah!
And some guy, some jerk, pulled the fire alarm. And so now everyone's outside. I know.
Over a movie.
Oh. Wow.
I don't know.
Well, hopefully we can see this when we get inside. Yeah, I hope it's a good movie. I've heard a lot of good things. And hopefully I'm not completely exhausted for work tomorrow morning. Gracias, señor.
Let's go.
Aha. Very large crowd. Wait, Ken, wait. Wait for me, Ken. Ken, wait. This way. Follow the masses. I'm coming to this. All right.
Which one's nine?
Which one? What TV are we on?
Nine.
Where's the nine? I'm sure. Maybe it's over there. Is it over there?
Whatever.
All right. We got leg room. We're gonna watch the movie. Are you excited?
Finally, yeah.
So yeah, finally after like what 30 minutes of like standing in a line.
Oh my! And then in the rain.
Yeah, in the rain. Are you excited?
I'm excited.
There's a huge bop here.
Who's that?
I just started reading the text.
From who?
I think it's from.
Is that from Albert?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's not Albert.
That's...
Oh, it is Albert.
Yeah.
There's so many people here to see it.
I told them there was a fire alarm.
I saw. It's a huge bob here. That's awesome.
All right.
Let's get it started. I'll give you guys a review on my next vlog.
That's a lie.
No, it is. No, I'll give a review on the next vlog.
I know, I'm just kidding.
You be quiet. Let me enjoy the movie.
Yes, sir.